I'm in Chicago with Thomas Schneeweis, and this is a real honor because Thomas is well known throughout the alternative investment community. Thomas co-founded the CAIA, the Chartered Alternative Investment Analyst Association, which is very well known. And then he is also the Mike and Sherry Phillips Chair at the Isenberg School of Management at the University of Massachusetts Amherst, and he's managing partner of S Capital. And what I'd like to do today, Thomas, is let's talk about the conversation we had at lunch, because we were talking about replication strategies. And there was that great article in the Wall Street Journal this past week, and they asked the question, can an ETF replicate a hedge fund strategy? And part of what you do at S Capital is strategy replication. So let me get your take on that. Can an ETF replicate a hedge fund strategy?
Like most things, yes and no. But certainly, in the particular article that you referred to, I think it was really an opportunity for individuals in the marketplace to get a sense to what is out there in terms of what are the new opportunities available to obtain access to various strategies that maybe until recently people regarded as outside of their particular venue. In this particular case, the article talked about using ETFs, as you mentioned, to capture some of the fundamental return to hedge funds. Now, I'm not sure how many of your readers are aware of this. All of them are, I would presume. You know that hedge funds have generally been called absolute return strategies.
Right.
And when they meant by absolute return, it was supposed to kind of make money in any market environment. Markets are going up, they could be long. Markets are going down, they had a chance to go short.
That's a big promise.
That was a promise. And like most things, it was partly true. But one of the reasons that they always talked about hedge fund managers, the hedge funds having this absolute return, is it was kind of manager-driven.
Mm-hmm. Alpha.
Alpha-driven, that all the return came from unique skills. Well, in reality, as in most things, when a lot of people do a strategy, there's a commonality in terms of how they approach, what they hold, the types of means and assets that they invest in. So, for example, equity long short. The word equity in there better tell you something. That predominantly they invest in the equity markets, and since equity markets generally have an upward bias, you'd like to believe they have a long-only bias, perhaps, to their underlying strategies. So in reality, hedge fund, equity long short in this particular case, has some expert individual managers who trade individual assets, but yet at the same point, a large part of their underlying return is, quote, market driven.
Beta.
And to the degree that one has an ETF that captures some of those particular areas that particular manager specializes in, technology, an ETF in the technology area. If it's an overall market, United States, if you want an ETF that captures the U.S. market, the S&P, or maybe a Russell ETF. If it's overseas, maybe an EM, if it's an emerging market ETF. You could use that particular ETF to capture a major portion of the directional return of that particular hedge fund manager with a lot more transparency and a lot more liquidity.
Interesting.
And that's really what the article, not that that can capture all of the alpha, but unfortunately, as you know, there's a lot of managers, but maybe only a few great managers. And it's not saying you can't be looking for hedge fund managers, but if you hope to create and hold a strategy that it captures what, in many cases, is the ability of a manager to kind of go long when it should be long, and short, perhaps a little more when they should be short, then there are techniques out there to use ETFs capture that core return to a particular hedge fund strategy. And that's what we do at S Capital Management.
Why don't you talk about that a little bit? Because this is a fascinating topic. When you replicate a strategy, what is your process? You start out and you have a methodology to it. And we're talking about that. Tell our viewers.
Well, first of all, again, I think your viewers are aware of the fact that, well, many people are aware of from this recent article, as the so-called the new world of asset tracking or hedge fund replication. In fact, it's been around a long time. Certainly in the early part of last decade, 2000, 2001, myself and some of my partners, Hussein Kassemi, wrote articles for Eurex on using futures contracts in order to replicate some of the fundamental hedge fund strategies. Back then, futures contracts were limited, primarily the equity and the fixed income. But still, by using futures contracts, as you well know, being someone who's done a lot of the work in the managed futures area, you can go long and you can go short.
Right.
So it's obviously true that you can use futures contracts to kind of capture a lot of what is going on in the hedge fund industry. In the middle of the 2000s, I ran a large managed account platform. And at that time, you would see the positions of a wide range of managers. Fortunately, people put money in and out of a platform. They want their money right away.
Right.
And it takes a little while to get money away from hedge fund managers. So one of the obvious things to do is to hold a portion of your money in liquid assets that replicate the fundamental strategy and use these so-called replication or positions that replicate the underlying manager as a way to handle the cash money moving in,
so
a, in and out.
So this is fascinating. It's a portfolio allocation method.
Exactly. Exactly what it is. So that advance in mid-2000s to the recent area, the world has changed again for us. And this is really what has allowed, this article mentioned here, a new way to approach tracking of hedge fund strategies and other strategies too in a more liquid and accessible form. ETFs. ETFs can go long, you can go short ETFs, there's options on ETFs. It gives you a broader range in order to, let's say, capture that underlying return strategy. And if you have a minute, I'll kind of tell you what we do.
I'd love to hear it, yeah.
Well, in reality, when we first came out, we were limited, as I mentioned.
Right.
And so, in fact, the whole tracking approach has had a little bit of a maturity over the years. You mentioned it originally, if you wanted to kind of track a strategy, you use a very simple one. You might use a S&P,
right,
ETF or a futures contract. With futures contracts or now with ETFs, you could get into maybe a Barclay Ag or a high yield and just use the major market sectors or factors to kind of capture that particular return. Call it a top-down.
Okay.
Where you would use, kind of capture the risk allocations of a particular hedge fund manager. But if you did that, you never could really capture the underlying holdings of a manager. So if you really want to capture the returns to a hedge fund manager, you just don't want the risk exposures. You'd like to have some way of capturing some of their asset allocation, as you mentioned, decisions.
Right. Exactly.
Do I want to be in technology? Do I want to take, do I want to go long health? Do I want to go short health? So strictly using a more risk-based approach, while it has its benefits, and some people do it in the marketplace, it is a limiting factor.
Mm-hmm.
The other way, of course, you go all the way from the bottom up.
Right.
I'm going to buy all the individual securities that that guy's holding, or that woman is holding. Go long the ones I think they're long, go short the ones, the individual securities that I think they should be short. Well, the problem with that, if you're going to go individual securities, go to the hedge fund manager. Or even if not, unfortunately, by using individual securities, bad things can happen to you. All of a sudden, Hewlett Packard, you find out, has a position in a European firm they bought a while back that they shouldn't have had. So you can see Apple, right? Apple can go up and Apple can go down dramatically.
Right.
So individual security replication of a hedge fund manager strategy has some of its risks, lack
sure.
of diversification. We found out that a better way is simply to use ETFs, which really allow us to capture the sector rotation. The asset allocation decision of a manager without necessarily being exposed either to the underlying security, and it offering you a greater sense of that manager's asset allocation than you would get from using an overall risk factor approach, only using four or five generic ETFs that capture the risk. I think that's important because in truth, what hedge fund managers really do, we think better than anybody else, is asset allocation.
Yeah,
and what you're really asking a hedge fund manager to do in contrast to a long-only manager is, you know, I don't think I want to be in technology. Maybe I want to go short technology. Maybe I want to go short healthcare. Maybe I want to go short gold. And so, in fact, if you can capture those so-called sector rotations in a manager, you will capture much more of what he or she is good at. Not perfect. You're not going to capture some of the individual security allocations. But you're going to give yourself transparency, the ETF's liquidity, be able to offer a system that adjusts by the regulatory rules over time. And we've been doing this since 2006.
Right.
We've had great success.
You've created a couple of benchmarks.
Well, yes. In 2006, when we first started doing it, we created an equity long-short tracker that was a hedge fund, if you want to call it that. We created a series of benchmark trackers that use, and anyway, this is kind of unique to our approach. Other people do it a little bit differently. Some of the first time that when tracking came out, they used monthly data.
Right.
I think you're familiar, I'm sure your audience is familiar with some of the monthly indices that are out in the marketplace.
Right.
CSDM has monthly indices, right. HFR has monthly indices. They don't do it for you.
Right. Well, daily can be a very different picture.
Well, to put it bluntly, people do trade during the middle of the month. and you wouldn't expect necessary monthly data to give you the kind of detailed analysis that you really require to do this. Daily data is required, we believe, at the very least. And what allows you, if you have daily data on the returns, and if you use a little bit of our special sauce, a little bit of mathematical adjustment that weights some of the more recent returns than the previous returns. Through daily data, you can get a very clear understanding of when a series of fund managers, individual managers in some case, or maybe an index or portfolio of the better performing equity long short managers in another case, really do change their overall holdings.
You know, it's interesting you mention that because S&P about a year ago adopted that immediate look back method for their managed futures replication model.
Yes, you know, there's different ways of approaching it. I think we've have an excellent we've been doing it for now, good piece, almost 6 years.
Wow.
Yeah. And we have benchmarks across on a daily basis, both now with we closed for our fund in the last couple of years. I've gotten old and decided to. But our partners still trade with partner money.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty much your model.
Broad range of strategy.
Your model is pretty much to develop the algorithm and then other people trade that algorithm.
Yeah, as you mentioned, there are specialists out there. One thing I've learned after X number of years of being in this industry, you have also, there's things that other people just do better than you. They right. do it every single day. There's quality folks. And there's no reason that you should do what they do well. And likewise, we believe they shouldn't do necessarily what you do well. And one of the things that we've done in my career is work with people, understand what their needs are, and then create, in this particular case, a tracking approach to various hedge fund strategies, the equity long short or merger ARB or convertible ARB, by using liquid ETFs. And we believe looking at the daily data, the underlying returns of these managers, using those daily returns and other existing assets to capture their sector rotations to give you a pretty good picture of what they do with greater transparency and greater liquidity. Let's be very honest, it doesn't do everything.
Right, no.
If you really need some days where the manager's returns were a little different, if gold goes up and they're in gold, you need that day when gold goes up. So that's the only way they could have had that is by being in gold. And that's how kind of you capture some of those unique movements. We've gone back and looked at daily data and monthly data, and your audience would be amazed. After maybe 2 or 3 days of particular movement, you're going to capture that particular relative switch of those particular managers into a different sector than they were maybe 2 or 3 days or four days before.
Right. Well, it's interesting you mentioned the development of these algorithms. You can look at past performance and get an idea of the market environments in which they performed and which they didn't perform, and then map that to a strategy. Fascinating work.
Well, I think you mentioned, I think one of the hardest things you have to do with your audience and anybody who's in our industry is that, hey, we have a tendency to promise a little more than we can deliver at times.
Well, that's what your book's all about, which is refreshing.
Yes, as you mentioned, we've had several books. The most recent was Postmodern Investment.
Right.
And the number one that's coming up by John Wiley, you can put a plug here.
Okay,
go for it. This month. And really, one of the number one visions of that particular book is that in today's world, change is a fundamental part of what is about us.
Right.
And that change causes good things. As I tell my students, if things didn't change, you'd hire a monkey and you could feed it bananas. So you need change. That having been said, change means that something that we've just been doing in the past may be a little bit dated.
Right.
You really can't look at the 90s. We've been in this industry a long time. You can't look at hedge funds of the 1990s and say that's how they would perform today. We have different instruments, different times, different securities, different regulation, different markets. And so when you're looking at the performance of a particular strategy, I know people that say, well, I want to go back 10 or 20 years. No, just the opposite. Going back 10 or 20 years to see how a strategy performs doesn't tell you really very much about how a strategy performs in today's market.
Right. Well, that ties into your look back concept with the benchmark.
Exactly. When you look at benchmarks, you really need, if I go back more than 2 or 3 months, do you think a manager's an active manager's return process is very well described what they were doing a year ago or 2 years ago?
Not particularly if it's a discretionary manager. Yeah,
especially if
no.
It's a discretionary manager. By the way, is again, for full disclosure, these tracker strategies don't work well for all strategies.
Right.
It works much better for a strategy, a manager who has a particular well-defined approach to how they choose assets and don't choose assets. For a pure discretionary manager that can change his trading style on a whim each day based on that.
It's impossible.
And you wouldn't expect it because, right. Let's be honest, if everything worked all the time, you'd get the risk-free rate. But we think we've approached a lot of stuff, and we mentioned here the article in the Wall Street Journal, I think it's opened up for many of your readers, hopefully, a better look back at what is out that allows them to capture, for a major part of their assets management, a particular strategy benefit, okay? And then leave for that other little 10% of their money to find those one or two extra managers, right, who really do something special that add to their particular portfolio. So we think a combination of a tracker approach that captures the principal mean or so-called return process of a particular strategy, and add on to it custom managers that you believe have some special sauce above what the transparency and liquidity offered by the tracker approach, is probably where things are going in the postmodern investment world.
Fascinating conversation, and let's stay in touch. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of developments relative to this.
Well, thank you for letting me talk, and I did most of the talking, but you asked all the good questions, and I think most people know it's the questions are the important thing.
No, people want to listen to you. They don't want to listen to me.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate your time.
Good to see you.
Very good.